You just watched 5 of the smoothest jump cuts that you can make in DaVinci Resolve, and you probably didn't even realize it. So let's jump on in and see how you can make that. Okay, so to get started with this, I just want to play it through without any of the jump cuts done, nothing smoothest done, exactly how it was shot. So let's jump right into there to do that. You just watched 5 of the smoothest jump cuts that you can make in DaVinci Resolve, and you probably didn't even realize it. So let's jump on in and see how you can make that. All right, so that's how that looks without any cuts being done to it. Let's scroll it back over here. And really quickly, I'm going to cut this up. I'm not going to explain how I'm cutting. I'm using this mouse. I have everything set up on the buttons. Makes my workflow much easier. So I'm just going to do it really quickly. Just make sure that was good. Resolve, and you probably didn't even realize it. I may actually throw in an extra jump cut there. Just get rid of that breath. So let's jump on in and see how you can make that. All right, so now that we've got it cut, I want to show you how does it look like with a couple of the cuts before we smooth them out. So we'll start right here, and let's pay attention to these first couple cuts. 5 of the smoothest jump cuts that you can make in DaVinci Resolve. All right, so we see how jumpy they are. So what we're going to do to make that smooth is we're going to come over here, make sure that you select your effects, and then you're going to come down here to where it says smooth cut. We're just going to drag that right over here. This is designed by DaVinci Resolve specifically for jump cuts to try to blend these together. So what you do is you put it there, and let's take a look and see how a smooth cut looks. 5 of the smooth. So you can see maybe like the fingers were a little bit fluttered there, but we can smooth that out even more. So what we're going to do is we're going to select our transition, and we're going to come over here and make sure that you select your inspector, and over here to transition, you can see it's on smooth cut and it says 25 frames. So I'm going to bring this down to 4. And now you can see it has shrunk this down by quite a bit. So let's take a look and see what it looks like with just the smooth cut. 5 of the smoothest. So you can see it smoothed it out pretty good. It can use a little finessing, and that's what I'm going to do later on. And that's most likely what you did see in the actual intro. But for the purpose of this video, to keep it nice and short, I'm just going to move along with this. What I'm going to do is create this as a preset. So I'm going to right click on here. We're going to come down to create transition preset. And you can see where that came up. Now I've done this already, so I'm just going to create a name for, like, say, DaVinci Smoothest Cut. Press OK. Now that is saved as a preset. You do not see it pop over here, but if I click on search and then we start typing that DaVinci, so as you can see, it came up here. And what I'm going to do is I'm not just going to utilize this. I'm going to come over here to where this little star is. This little star means it adds it to your favorites. So if you click on that, now we don't have to look it up. So I click that. Let me eliminate what I was looking under here to find it. And you see it's gone. So if I come over here to my favorites, it will pop up there. You see DaVinci Smoothest Cut. So yeah, I've already got what I use, but I'm going to utilize one we just made. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select all the clips that we just cut apart so you can see how to apply it to all of them at once. So now we come over back to the one that we just created, and we're going to right click that, and we're going to come down to add to selected edit points and clips. Now you can also set it as a standard transition, but I'm just doing it this way. And now there it is. So now it has the smooth cut on all of them. And let's just see how the rest of them look like after putting that on there. jump cuts that you can make in DaVinci Resolve, and you probably didn't even realize it. So let's jump on in and see how you can make that.
All right, so really smoothed out. Most of them blend right on in together. A little finessing, and it's going to be perfect.
Before we continue on to the next half of the video, I just wanted to take a moment to introduce myself. My name is Chad. I make DaVinci Resolve tutorials and create systems and processes which will help you streamline your workflow. This way, you can focus more on your business. I really enjoy helping others, especially when it comes to the business. So if you have any questions, you can feel free to leave a comment below. And I would really appreciate if you would give me a thumbs up and subscribe. For the second half of the video, I want to show you what not to do when you're recording to make the jump cuts, or what you can teach your clients to do. A lot of times when we're speaking to the camera, we make pauses, kind of like that. And what you really should do is try to just stop in that moment, keep your body where it was, and maybe even your hands. Then you start talking again, and it's so easy to cut that and allow it to go smooth and seem like you never did anything. So this is a good way that you can show to your clients to make everything run nice and smooth. So let's watch this and see what not to do. I'm gonna press Command F, make it full screen for you, and let's play it. You just watched five of the worst jump cuts that I could make because I'm just constantly moving around. So as we can see how horrible that is, and obviously you're gonna know that it was pretty bad. So I'm just really quickly going to cut through these and be right back with you. So now I am going to apply the smooth cut to those clips, and we're going to watch them through and see how horrible they are. You just watched five of the worst jump cuts that I could make because I'm just constantly moving around. So I highly recommend that you work with your clients or yourself. If you have a pause like this and then you continue on, just try to stay in that position before you go do that, if this is something that is necessary to make your video nice and smooth. So that is how you make the smoothest cuts in DaVinci Resolve, apply to every single cut, and create your own preset to do it. You know, according to the Google algorithm and your watch habits, they believe that this video would be the best one for you to watch next. So please go ahead and take a look at that and let me know what you think in the comments below.